Well, the Walker County Sheriff's Office is investigating after a child was left in a hot car over the weekend.
11-month-old Jackson Taylor passed away on Saturday after his grandparents and his aunt left him in a car for more than 2 hours. News Channel 9's Catherine Marchand joins us now with more on that story. Catherine.
Kim, Lauren, Walker County Sheriff Steve Wilson told me that he believes Jackson was left in the car accidentally and that his family simply miscommunicated and forgot to get him out of the car. Today I spoke with experts about what causes a parent to forget.
Experts say in over half of the cases of children dying in hot cars, caregivers unknowingly forgot the child in the vehicle. But how does that happen? Psychologist Dr. Susan Hickman of the Mental Fitness Institute says the brain has a subconscious memory for everyday routines and a short-term memory for things that aren't done on a regular basis.
It's what you're trying to hold in place in this moment. Remember to pick up your car keys. Don't forget your shoes. Don't forget the kids, right? So you've got that. And that's the one that gets most interfered with when you're stressed.
She says when something isn't a habit, it's easy to forget, especially when stress or exhaustion is added to the mix.
Most of us think, you know, when we hear these reports, it's like, oh my God, how could you forget your child, right? And then it has such devastating consequences. However, it's interesting because what is happening is really multifaceted.
National nonprofit Kids in Cars works to keep children safe around motor vehicles. President Jeanette Fennell says putting your purse in the back seat of the car, replacing a stuffed animal in the front seat, can remind you to check on your child before exiting your car.
This can help you remember. So if the stuffed animal isn't up front, it's in the car seat. And if it is up front, the baby's in the car seat. So just some of these very, very simple, straightforward safety tips literally can mean the difference between life.
What you're doing by putting a stuffed animal in the front seat or your purse in the back seat is you're cueing yourself, because picking up your purse is probably very, very routinized. So it's, you know, in that subconscious level. And so if you reach for your purse and it's not there, now you're absolutely going to look around and find it.
Fennell also suggests whenever you arrive to your destination, just take a couple of seconds and open the back door of your car. For more safety tips, you can visit kidsincars.org. Kim?
Catherine, thank you.